Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition Shadows of Arm Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, missing Lilarkor's little quips when the game loads up. Okay, so, right, that's the exit. But we don't want to leave yet because there's stuff to explore around here. Maybe after we see whatever this stuff is, maybe we can go back up and grab Dorne. Maybe he'll stay with us. I don't know. I don't want to leave him here.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
But he either wants to stay here, attack us and stay here, or somehow teleport to the Radiant Order of the Noble Heart, whatever it's... the Paladin headquarters. And we can't be doing that. I don't know what that would do. Oh. I thought that was a closed door. Oh, wait, so. That's the exit. And what's that? Oh, I forgot. Didn't realize that was there.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Gotcha.
I hear scary monsters. Scary monster. Oh, wait. Oh, these match those paintings, don't they? Well, she has them all. Pretty cool looking. I like them. But they're probably going to be removed. So this is, this one. Painting of a djinn. Whoop! And, yeah, I guess I shouldn't be that surprised.
Good to go. Right you are.
Wait, hold on. Kill that. Why are we not, yeah, advancing toward the enemy?
Yep. All right, all right. Ultranon!
No issue there. Skydrop gem.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
So did the painting disappear? It did. Alright. Oh, we're almost out of these for bullet plus one will be next. Okay. Anyone else holding on to any bullets? It looks like the only one we have are these regular bullets. Yeah, we've been going through them. Okay, so this is... this is... Man, I don't want to find another mind flayer. This is Troll, I think, right? Yeah, Troll painting.
No problem at all.
I wonder who drew these amateurish paintings. There's no troll.
You can count on.
Oh, it's right there. Ah, that's no good.
This way, then.
Hmm. past it with looking for invisibility purge. And she's going over there. Staying on her.
Name it. Good to go?
Your life shall be mine.
Reveal yourself.
Right is right.
How many of these do I have left? Okay.
Fine, I'll help however I can.
Let's use up this dinky little wand of magic missiles.
Such menial tasks.
Gotcha. Ability score drained. Oh, strength. He's lost strength.
I stand back for justice.
A den of stinking justice. All right, we need to. We got any strength potions? Let me grab this. I thought I grabbed it. Okay, no. Grab this. Malachar plus two. This sleek katana radiates magical energy when carried. The Malachar, or dueling steel, was used by a less than honorable samurai during duels against other samurai. As if of its own volition, it will swoop down and deflect the slashing attacks of other weapons. It is perfect for the warrior concerned about defense as well as offense. Well, the best defense is a good offense. Okay, so armor class is plus two versus slashing weapons on it. Otherwise it's just a normal 1d10 plus two with echo plus two. Yoshima is proficient in katana. Shame. Alright, let's see what we have to give people some strength back. Because I don't know if greater restoration or lesser. I don't know if it works that way. That's lesser. This is greater. Oh, we'll also restore the intelligence score of a creature affected by the feeble mind spell and negate any form of insanity, such as confusion or berserk. Fully heals and cures any diseases or poisons. So that might be it, but we don't have that memorized. And I don't think Aerie has access to level 7 priest. No. Maybe we'll just rest? I mean, last time we rested, and it was fine after that.
Ready and willing.
What can I do?
You can heal. Oh, didn't realize. All right, switch.
And the dead.
Where's that other, this one here? One more. Why not? Okay.
A simple matter.
Faster than Chiktika fast paws.
Fine.
I'll do it.
Man, I hope this Slayer thing doesn't take over my character. Like, I don't know what would happen at that point.
Right you are.
You point. See battle bow. Run, bow, run!
Imowyn saying I'm right.
I shall follow your strength.
So I don't have this memorized, right? The delayed blast fire. Well, it's probably going to hurt us. Because I would place a delayed blast fireball, like, over here or something. I don't know if that's how it even works. Yeah, I don't think I have that memorized. Which one is delayed blast fireball, right? I don't see it. Sphere of Chaos. That's it. Mm-hmm. 15 d6 points of damage. That's amazing. But I don't have it memorized. Let's rest before we fight Mind Flayer and what else? We've got a Mind Flayer and an Umber Hulk to deal with. I already saved. Oh, good. Wow. All right, so this... All right, this is the Umber Hulk, then.
All right, all right.
Fald.
A den of stinking evil.
There's stuff back here.
Cover your nose, Boo. We will leave no crevice untouched.
Maybe if we go more in the dark here.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Maybe that did it. I keep trying to get it to
now you see me, now you don't.
Do some kind of backstab, but it never works. She always misses. Oh, I can't. Those are the switch weapons. I don't want to mess it up.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Well, now she can't get past him.
Something up. Nope.
Okay, go.
You can count on me.
swords, not words!
This way, no then. Mercy for those who oppose us! Gotcha. Time to move. Good to go.
No.
Such menial tasks. This is a lot more exciting than any circus.
Okay. Has been chopped.
Right, you are.
Skewered. Right, I am. This continues on, but this ends here, so we just fight the Mind Flayer. Oh, I didn't check. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, strength is back. But now we're going to lose intelligence.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Alright, alright!
No traps. She's been standing there for a while.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Hmm? In Baravan's name. It shall be done.
A simple matter.
But kicking for goodness!
Destiny awaits.
We'll be closer by, nearby here.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Now, Natha.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Now you don't. Now you see me?
I figured that things will, like, wander out of there or something. my prison is open. No, I'll just stay here. You're gonna miss, aren't you? Olitharid. Nice! Triple damage. Run, Imowen.
No problem.
Your life shall be mine.
Oops. Oh, she's doing. I don't like that devourer brain thing here. Bolt of glory. Oh, we should use the skeletons. Dual Bolt of Glory.
Mince and booze and many.
Haste. Yeah. That'll teach her.
Fine.
Yes, a dose quiet.
Don't teach my hamster.
Okay.
Dost.
Resurrecting. Yeah, so she doesn't get. She doesn't get fatigued from that.
Yep.
Take that.
This place is just too darn creepy. I really want out of here.
I know, you just got your brain sucked out by a mind flare. It's past creepy and into actively dangerous. Wrong item type. Oh. Need to find you more gear. All right, we have. Here, take his ring of regeneration. It's Doran anyway. This is yours too. I'd never have you wear it. Okay, she regenerates now. Yay! Cure critical, Minsk. It needs 31 points back. Topping off. Okay, you got all your stuff. And now, Flame of the North plus 2. The title does not refer to the blade itself, but rather to the woman who originally wielded it in the icy hinterlands of Faerûn. Her name was Carrera, and she was a veritable firestorm that swept across Arctic trolls and the northern orcish tribes. She was a hated enemy of many a shaman whose magic often floundered against her fury. After a lifetime of raucous battle, it was old age that eventually claimed her. The sword was passed to her granddaughter, an adventurer who presumably brought it to Am. Ooh, magic resistance plus 10%. I think that's the highest we've seen magic resistance so far in an item. 1d10 plus 2, plus 4 extra damage every round versus chaotic evil, as long as you hit. And Thaco plus 2. Okay, so he has this plus 2 weapon, Daystar. An additional 1d6 points of damage per level of caster. I'm guessing sword wielder, actually. Well, it's really good against undead. It's a 1d8 plus 2 plus 4 versus evil creatures. Double damage against undead. Plus 4 extra versus chaotic evil. 1d10 plus 2. I'll give him this one. Oh, this is a two-handed weapon? I didn't even realize. Yeah, it is pretty long. Okay, for some reason it looked like his other. Yeah, it's longer. Yeah, bigger. Alright, never mind. It's a non-issue. I prefer to have him dual wielding.
You can count on me.
Why does a mind flayer even have that sword anyway?
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
He's lost her haste when
this
she died.
Way, then?
Yeah, this way. Oh wait, no. No, this way.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Hmm. Interesting.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Gotcha.
Now you see me, now you don't.
A A stone golem. Hmm.
Good to go.
Every stand back for justice!
The stone ones aren't that bad. It's the clay ones that I really can't stand. Oops. Oh, I saw us.
Armored, sharpened, and raring to go!
Alright. Much well, right you are.
Go this way.
I'll do my best.
Me too.
Such menial tasks.
Time to go. Now she's using this, which is 1d6 plus 2. It's not undead, so it's the Thakos plus effectively plus 3. 1d6 plus 2. Or we have this with added electrical damage. 1d4 plus 3. Okay, we'll switch to this. This is going to be what hurts it the most. It's a bludgeoning weapon, at least I'm pretty sure. That's how it works. That's how it works against the clay golems, anyway.
Alright.
Oh, we defeated it. Okay. Aerie's drowning in her own blood. Let's help her. Okay. No one's hurt. By the elithid. Forgot to check.
See battle bow! Run, bow, run!
Mm-hmm.
No problem at all.
Alright. More of these mithril tokens. A diamond. A scroll of maze and darts of wounding, I think these are. Yeah. Add that there. I would like to learn maze. Who's holding these things? Conia has them, okay. We'll just stack that in there. Now we have 8 of these mithril tokens. No idea what they're for. I assume we're gonna find out. Alright, so we're gonna learn maze. Level 8. Now we've been mazed, but we have never mazed ourselves. Area of effect is 1 creature. No saving throw. An extra-dimensional space is brought into being under utterance of a maze spell. The subject vanishes into the shifting labyrinth of force planes for a period of time that is totally dependent upon its intelligence. Really? Intelligence of target and time trapped in maze. So you can see this under 3 is 2d4 turns. 1d4. Oh, and then it turns 6 to 8 turns into rounds. 5d4 rounds. Finally, 18 and up intelligence, 1d4 round. So you can only be missing for a round if you have really good intelligence. Note that if the 9th level spell Freedom is cast in the area where a creature was mazed, it will effectively bring her back to this plane, ending the spell prematurely. Note that a mazed creature is not freed through dispel magic. Alright. done. And it's level 8. Alright. I do want to check out Simulacrum, but I want to check out Maze. Yeah.
You can count on me.
But when battle breaks out, I can tend to just use the same tried and true spells. Alright, 213 gold. 3 more of these mithril tokens. And yeah, I don't want these throwing daggers or throwing axes. Well, they only stack 10. Right, so we got a new stack of them.
Ready and willing. Just like old times. Well, except for the torture and all.
Mm-hmm. Alright, we've also got whatever's back here.
This way, then? Now you see me, now you don't.
Oh, we've got a device.
Now you see me, now you don't.
There's nothing in here. It's just this device. Let's come back for that. Well, that's a door that's already open. Or it's a door into this room. Never mind. It is open, never mind.
Now you see me, now you don't.
Here's a clay golem, but it's two of them, but not hostile. Three.